If you're stuck on a low-end PC, one of the most frustrating things is to see how Windows 10 becomes more and more bloated with every single update and consumes more and more of your precious PC resources. The same ones that you usually need to run programs, or in the case of the channel, play games. It is no wonder that a video optimizing Windows itself is very, very high on the list of the most frequently requested topics. Okay, before that, let's start with what we're actually trying to achieve here. In most cases, a game will not run with the desired performance because of a GPU bottleneck. And as far as I have measured, modifying Windows will not affect GPU performance, especially in full-screen mode. However, Windows, even while idle, uses a significant amount of RAM and has random spikes of CPU usage. For example, I checked my Athlon 200GE computer on a fresh and fully updated install of Windows 10, and 1.6 gigs of RAM were used with nothing else opened, along with the expected random spikes of CPU usage. 8GB can already be low for certain games, when two of those are used for VRAM for an integrated GPU, and almost two more are used by Windows. On my video for the GPD Pocket 2, I explored a more critical case where half of the RAM was taken by Windows already. But I decided to go even further. This Intel stick only has 2 gigabytes of RAM. This Intel Atom PC uses Windows 10 32 bits, and that allows it to save some memory. But even with that, it still uses 1.2 gigabytes of RAM, which is more than 60% of all available memory. So, what can you do if you want to minimize that? Option 1 is to install an older but still supported OS like Windows 7, which is tricky because it does not initially support certain components like the eMMC memory of the Pocket 2, making installation very difficult on newer super thin PCs. Option 2 is to install Windows 10 Lite, a very unofficial hack of Windows 10 aimed at using as little resources as possible, which means possibly downloading an OS from a very unsecured source and having some programs that do not work correctly. I go more into depth on that option on my GPD Pocket 2 video. This video is option 3, taking your existing Windows 10 installation and removing everything we can to make it lighter. So let's get started with decrapifying Windows 10. Let's discuss the conventional stuff first. There's a set of tips that I have seen all over the web a million times when the topic of Windows optimization is searched for, such as disable all notifications, go into the visual properties of Windows and select the best performance. In all my gaming tests, this do close to nothing. So I'm going to focus on the ones where I actually measure some difference. For example, disabling Game Bar on the options, the annoying overlay that Windows 10 has for games, making sure Game DVR, the Windows software that records game footage, is disabled, and that the typical power plant change is in high performance. This is especially useful on laptops, which tend to be a bit more conservative on power usage. But you have probably heard all of this before. The still common but still not mentioned enough is to check your task manager to make sure you minimize the amount of stuff that starts every time your PC boots. This is going to be especially important now that we're getting a million launchers for every game and you do not want all of those auto-starting every time you turn off. Also, make sure you hit run and then msconfig and check which services start with Windows as well. Hide the Microsoft services and try to remove as many as you can from what is left. Do be wary that some of these services are needed for certain programs. Steam, for example, will not run if you do not start its service from boot, and I have seen a couple of anti-cheat fails as well, so take note of what you disabled, and if a program fails to start, see if you need to re-enable its service. Okay, we're done with that. You have likely heard of those before too. Let's get to the good stuff. This is the Bloat Windows 10, a set of scripts by GitHub user Warhack designed to remove as many services and as many default apps from Windows 10 as possible. Now let me make this very clear. This technique does not support Creator Update, and technically it does not support Windows Home, and it is also technically for administrators that know what you're doing. But I have tested this on a fully updated Windows 10 Home with very good results. However, for the love of God, create a restore point before doing this and back up your files. You are doing this on your own risk. Okay? Excellent. Step 1, go to Settings and Update Windows. Hit that Update button and install everything until Windows is updated. And there's nothing more to update. This is generally a good practice because Windows might be updating in the background while you play a game and making your PC very slow without you knowing why. Believe me, every time an update is issued, I notice because all my test PCs suddenly go super slow. And in this case, if you run the script while Windows is updating, bad stuff can happen, so make sure you are updated. Step 2. Download the set of scripts from the GitHub link in the description. Extract it and put it in a folder on a location that you can remember easily, like C. Or you can leave it in the downloads and struggle to navigate, like I did. Because for step 3, you're going to have to open the Windows PowerShell as administrated by right-clicking it. And here's where things get interesting. You need to navigate to a folder called Scripts inside the folder that you extracted. If you have never used a command line before, you can simply change directory by using the command cd. cd dot dot takes you one folder up from the place that you currently are. You will likely start in Windows System 32, so if you do cc dot dot, you end up in a Windows folder, and then cd dot dot to navigate to the main C drive. You can also use cd to go into a folder accessible from where you are by simply doing cd name of the folder. Use this to navigate to the scripts folder that you extracted. In there, you need to do this command to enable all scripts, and these two commands to unblock the scripts in that folder. You will have to press yes on a couple of prompts to actually confirm this. Then, if you use the ls command, you will see a set of scripts with very descriptive names that you should maybe all run. And you can run it simply by writing its full name with the extension and pressing enter. You will occasionally have to follow some instructions and type R to run the script. These scripts not only will disable a lot of the background telemetry services, but remove a ton of default apps from the system. One of them will disable Windows Defender, which can use a fair bit of background power, but be aware that you will basically be without an antivirus, so only use this if you know what you're doing and not downloading stuff from unknown sources. It will take some time to run each script, and the Windows Manager will reboot when you have run the last one. There's also this code snippet by GitHub user Matthew Gerberg that does overlap with some of the stuff we have already done, but also disable some extra services as well. This one is easier. All you need to do is to save its contents on a .bat file, and then open a command line as administrator, navigate to where that .bat is stored, and write its name. Oof, that was a mouthful, but the results are good news. You will notice that without search, the start menu is a bit harder to use, so I will also link to a program that substitutes that for the classic start menu of Windows 7. And look, the numbers speak for themselves. On my base 8GB PC, usage dropped from 1.6 all the way to 1.1. Wow, that is going to be useful for VRAM. The more extreme case is the Intel stick that went from 1.2 to 0.7, which means that we have more than half the RAM for games. How good is that? While the effects of the lower CPU usage are going to be harder to notice due to the fact that anything we play on this is going to be severely GPU bottleneck, we can still see how now we have more room to avoid running out of memory, or how CPU spikes are greatly reduced. Tomb Raider running on 800x600 is a good example. I applied the changes documented in its own video and saw a resulting average of over 30 FPS on the benchmark, limited by the tiny integrated GPU of this thing. However, keep in mind that when using integrated GPUs, the regular RAM is also used as VRAM, which increases the overall memory used by a game, and when we jump into an actual game with actual combat, you start seeing the memory usage climb closer to all the memory available. And yet, the game does not crash or stutter, so this is a great example of how that extra memory gain from Windows is proving in handy. A harder example is Rocket League. As time goes on, as many multiplayer games do, I have noticed that this game has increased its RAM usage quite a bit. So much that even after executing all the scripts, if I run the game with Afterburner, it will exit with an out-of-memory error, as I discovered on the test stream for this video.
Oh god, I haven't played this game in a while. It's so fun, but run out of video memory! Oh, okay, we're doing fine. We're doing fine. This is an excellent beginning.
Thankfully, by closing Afterburner and relying purely on the in-game FPS meter, we did actually manage to free up enough memory to play the game for a full hour without any crashes during matches that I all streamed here in YouTube. I did have to lower the resolution dramatically using the internal scaler of the file, as explained in a video I did a fair bit ago for this game, but apart from the GPU bottleneck, there was definitely enough RAM to play the game most of the time.
That actually worked. Wow, and the game hasn't crashed, so... never mind.
I had to talk, didn't I?
There was still a possibility of the game crashing while unloading after a match, but after decrapifying Windows and removing Afterburner, it did work and did not crash in the middle of a single match. And that, if anything, is a sign of how these changes can help you.
Oh, we're going to have a much harder time with this one. Oh, come on! Okay.
My moment has arrived!
Yes! Oh, yes. Amazing.
Oh, come on! Oof. Beautiful.
It's so easy to understand, yet so hard to actually play competently. And I'm dead.
So take note of these scripts, maybe you can customize Windows to get the best out of your low-end PC. And with all the newfound space left by that cleanup, what should you install? Maybe something for your security. Maybe install Dashlane. Okay, that was a good transition. Okay, for real, Dashlane is the second thing I get for any fresh OS install at this point, and quite honestly, it is a godsend. Did you hear that
2.2 billion
passwords and email combinations are floating in the dark web these days? I've been checking some of the websites monitoring the leak, and there are several instances of the password associated with the email that I use for my YouTube channel. If I had continued using the same password for everything as I used to do years ago, I would have been screwed. But I'm not. The way Dashlane works is that it helps generate safe passwords for all your accounts and puts them on an encrypted storage. So you only need to remember your master password and nothing else. Not even Dashlane knows your master password, so even if they get hacked, your passwords are safe. Also, Basic Dashlane is free. You can get Premium, which as I have said in the past, I personally pay and use every day, which means your encrypted storage gets synced between devices, so you can use it in your phone, use an exclusive VPN for public connections, or my favorite service, Dark Web Monitoring, that tells you when one of these passwords has been leaked online, like those terrifying headlines. If you want to give it a try, the first 200 people to use the code on screen get a 10% discount on their annual premium subscription. Seriously, it is less than $5 a month. If you work online and a password leak could literally mean going bankrupt, it is nothing for a zero-effort layer of security. Thank you to them for sponsoring this video, and you for watching this. And watching the stream, and not spamming the chat with video requests, and understanding that I'm just a guy making videos and not some game service for you to yell at. I should take a break.